Number 14, Florida, taking down number 1, Maryland, 15-14 in a thrilling game Saturday. The Gators snapped Maryland's home win streak of 86 games, which was the longest current home win streak in all of D1 sports this season. Yeah, this season is off to a crazy start already. Four of the top five teams in the country have already been upset. As we mentioned, the Terps getting downed by the Gators Friday night. Number 3 Northwestern got outlasted by number 6 Notre Dame, 17-15. And earlier in the week, unranked Stony Brook stunned the 4th-ranked Syracuse women, while UMass got the best of number 5 Boston College, 15-11. So, as we said, UNC last one standing.
I mean, Notre Dame moves to 2. Is that, if we're thinking about this, you know, they're number 6 now, 3, 4, 5 all lost. Just doing the math.
Good math.
We'll see what happens. All right, let's get to other things going on. After being down early to Penn, 4th-ranked Maryland scored 8 unanswered goals to rally back and beat the Quakers 17-15, second straight week with a comeback for Maryland. Daniel Maltz led the way in goals for the Terps, scoring 5 of the 17, 4 of which were tallied during the 8-0 run. Jared Bernard also having himself a day at 6 points, 4 goals, and 2 assists as Maryland advances to 3-0 this season. Duke and Denver facing each other for the 11th time in the last 10 years. Denver with a 6-4 advantage heading 6-4 advantage heading into this one, but the Blue Devils had a 5-goal lead in the first quarter, never looking back. Sophomore Owen Caputo, 6 points, 3 goals and 3 assists in the top 10 triumph. Duke's offense firing on all cylinders. 8 different goal scorers on this one. The win pushes them to 2-1 on the year. The home loss was just the 10th for the Pioneers since 2010.
And Yale opened up their season against Villanova on Saturday. The Bulldogs had dropped the season opener to the Wildcats the last 2 seasons, but not this time, scoring 7 in the first quarter alone, ultimately winning 18-12. The Bulldogs' offense was led by Thomas Bragg with 4 goals, 2 assists.
Casanova.
Oh,
Casanova, New York.
Love that hometown connection.
Yeah.
Matt Brando with 3 goals, 3 assists. TD Ireland established yet another NCAA record for ground balls with a whopping 762. I didn't think that was right. I asked you earlier like 5 times because that just sounds absurd.
Amazing.
But good for him.
That's crazy.
Yeah. And Rutgers took its first loss Saturday to number 13 Army with a final score of 15-4. Army jumped out to an early 3-goal lead, and despite their best efforts, Rutgers could not catch up as that gap just kept on widening. Jacob Morin with 5 of those 15 goals for Army. Sean O'Brien right behind with 4 points, a hattie and an assist. Brendan Nickturn was the setup man all day, 3 assists.
Princeton starting their season with a 20-9 win over Monmouth, and Michael Sowers turned in one of the best performances we've seen all season, tying a Princeton school record with 11 points. Scored 4 goals, dished out 7 assists, also adding 2 cause turnovers. Penn State improving to 3-0 with a 19-4 win over St. Joe's. Mack O'Keefe scoring 6 goals. Grant Ament assisting on 4 of those 6 to O'Keefe. Ament ended up with 6 assists and a goal. Colby Canese making 12 saves. Penn State takes on Yale next weekend. I can't wait for that one.
Big weekend coming up. And a week after falling to number 1 Virginia, the Loyola Greyhounds get in win number 1, 10-7, the final score over 11th-ranked Johns Hopkins. Kevin Lindley scoring 4 goals in the win for Loyola after missing the Blue Jays opener against Towson. Joey Epstein making his first appearance but did not get on the scoreboard. A big day for the 2 teams that finished at the bottom of the CAA. Dylan Beckwith's 8 points guiding the Fairfield Stags to an 18-16 win over Stony Brook, getting Andrew Baxter's first win as a head coach in his first game. On Long Island, Hofstra's Ryan Tierney, 4 goals, 4 assists in the Pride's 12-9 win over Michigan. Hofstra moving to 2-0 on the season.